Let's go! Wow, check this out, guys. We are right now forming potentially a double bottom. So if we break through this line, the price is most likely going to have a significant breakout to the upside. So you need to watch this video right now. This is vital information. If you're holding Bitcoin or any other cryptocurrency, also we're talking about Ethereum because things are really, really gearing up right now. Look at this triangle on Ethereum on the 4-hour chart. So this is extremely important. And not only this is also lining up with what we are seeing on the Ethereum to Bitcoin chart, because right now we are inside of this triangle again. And are we about to break here through this level to the upside, both on the Bitcoin to Ethereum chart and also to the Ethereum to USD chart? That is, guys, that is going to probably be significant and take us above our previous all-time high. So stick around for that. We're also following up on traditional markets. So we closed yesterday with 3 red candles. How is this going to impact Bitcoin right now? If you've been watching any of my previous videos, you know that the traditional markets, they are very, very important to what's going on with Bitcoin as well. And really, how well are we doing with Bitcoin right now? How well are we doing? Not only if you compare to previous halving cycles, everything is going completely according to plan, and that we are going to have some insane price targets here potentially in this cycle, and Bitcoin is outperforming other assets. So yes, you need to pay attention. Do not sell your Bitcoin. They are trying to fool you. So welcome back, everybody. My name is Cristiano, bringing you 3 cryptocurrency videos across 2 different channels every day. So if you are interested in technical analysis and price action, make sure to subscribe to the channel right now so that you do not miss out on very, very vital information. So with that said, let's get right into the chart right here. We are on the 1 hour, and you can see that my favorite pattern is right now forming. So what do we have here? Well, we have the price going down from a downtrend and forming a bottom, and then going up, forming a second bottom right here, which is higher than the first one. And now we are going up and we are testing this neckline. And if we break this, then technically, I mean, we are going to have a breakout up to the previous all-time high. This is actually pointing towards 40,416. And if we zoom out, it's not exactly at the previous all-time high, but it is in that vicinity. So expect some resistance right around this area, guys. In fact, let me just do another of my patented brown boxes. So this is what we need to break through, guys. So this is what we need to break through. I'm going to clean this up after. You can see that the price is actually extending further than these boxes. But anyhow, look at how beautifully we have been ranging inside of these 2 blue lines, actually. Now, let's get back to the double bottom. So what do we want to see here if this is actually going to be a tradable pattern? We are not going to trade this right now because you can see that the price is actually respecting the previous high right here on the wick. So we went up, we had a small rejection, and we actually retested it. But we are not going to trade this until we actually close a candle above this level. That is going to be very good. And zooming out, the trend is intact with higher lows. Low here, there, here. So that's what we're watching. Another thing I want to see is that I want us to, if I'm going to flip to become, you know, I'm pretty neutral right now. I expect us to range. I expect us to consolidate under the previous all-time high. But if I am going to become more bullish than I am right now, I mean, long-term, mid-term, I'm super bullish already. But if we take out this high, if we take out this high and can actually maintain that, I am going to be more bullish. I mean, significantly more bullish than I am right now. But there's another thing I want to talk about, and this is actually on the 4-hour chart. And you can see that we are forming this triangle. You can see we went up, we have a couple of touching points right here, a couple of touching points here, and then up. And you can also look at this on the 1 hour. But this is significant, guys. And if we were to have a breakout to the upside, I mean, we're looking at $50,000. If we're going to have a breakdown, that is potentially going to take us to $24,658. So now I want to ask you, what do you think is going to happen here? Do you think that this pattern is going to break to the up or to the downside? Let me know down in the comment section. But yes, pay attention to this double bottom here on the hourly as well. As always, I am going to keep you updated on Twitter. So before we talk a bit about Ethereum, let's talk about traditional markets and how it is actually compared to Bitcoin right now. So remember yesterday I showed you how Bitcoin is correlated with traditional markets, and some of you said like, okay, so if they are correlated, why don't we just trade the S&P 500 and traditional markets? Well, because let's go back here. If we flip on the comparison again, sure. I mean, it's following Bitcoin, or Bitcoin is following traditional markets in terms of swings and how the price is going up or down. But the gains are completely different, guys. Meaning, look at this run up. Now, I don't have the numbers in my head, but let's say on the S&P 500, this run up, this gave you a 10% profit. But on Bitcoin, that was going to give you a 46% profit. So it's following, but I mean, in terms of the swings percentage-wise, they're completely different. And at some point, what we're all waiting for is for Bitcoin to decouple from traditional markets, but we are not seeing that yet. So now, let's talk about Ethereum. This is insane. So you have this triangle on Ethereum right now. Oh, actually, before we do that, there was one thing I forgot. So if we look at the double bottom again here, the potential double bottom, I should say, this could also turn into a, because you can see that we are forming it as well, this could also be a triangle. So let me extend this neckline. You have the double bottom and you have the triangle, but the target is going to be the same. So it's all about breaking this level. Okay, so just wanted to show you that. But yes, you have the exact same triangle actually on Ethereum right now, but this is actually on the 4 hour. This is on the 1 hour. This is on the 4 hour. Target out of the breakout of this triangle above all-time high, but expect a lot of resistance here at all-time high. So that might be a good time to take profit, or if you want to ride it, perhaps take partial profit right here. But then you have the Ethereum to Bitcoin chart, and this is also lining up right now for a breakout. And if we break out of this, I mean, we are going to outperform Bitcoin by a 24% about. Meaning, if Bitcoin continues to go up, and we break out of this on Ethereum to Bitcoin, and also on Ethereum, I mean, this chart, that is going to be an insane push. Everything is lining up right now. I will keep you updated. So before we talk about how we are right now, if you look at previous halvings and what to expect, I want to share the craziest, this is the craziest success story I've ever seen. So I got this email saying that, you know, thanking me for the stuff I do, and I get those every once in a while, and I love doing that. So everything you make in terms of profit, it's all on you. If I can help you with that, that's fantastic for me. But look at this user, total deposit. And first off, I have to say, if you don't know what you're doing, you have to be careful. If you don't know how to trade and you haven't learned it properly, only trade with the money you would otherwise spend on coffee. So you are not going to be sad when you lose it, because you are going to make mistakes in the beginning. But yeah, and obviously also watch my trading tutorials. I have two of them on my YouTube channel. But look at this, $4,000 deposited the 26th of December, and this is USDT. So 26th of December, started trading, first day, volume of 26,000 USDT. So that's pretty much a 5x. So let's say the person did a 5x leverage with this deposit. It matches up with 26,519. And then it continues, 242 the day after. So this was a very good trade. It continues, 749 a couple of days later, and this gets insane. I mean, look at this. It goes to 654 and then 4.5 million. So this person, he or she, has made a couple of good trades. So from humble beginnings of 4,400, the 26th of January, this is the total deposits, 26th of January, a couple of days later, what is that, 2 weeks or so? A volume of 4.5 million USDT. So I just hope that you are taking some of the profits off the table. I pretty much know that you are going to do that. But take that, put it into your hodl position. And from the humble beginning of $4,400, this person is now a millionaire. So congratulations. I am happy if I in any way was able to help with that. And just like I said, be very careful. But if you want to trade this volatility, you are able to get a bonus on Bybit. So sign up using my link right here. You're going to get $1,150 in bonus if you use this code in the rewards hub section. So yes, big congratulations, but let's continue now. So let's look at this. Bitcoin after the third halving. So if you compare the price right now compared to the previous halvings, we are on track to reach insane targets right now. So first off, what are we looking at? Well, this is the average. This gray line is the average gains price, so to speak, if you compare the previous halvings. And then you have the growth range defined by the previous halvings being the blue here. So you can see that we are well on track right now. In fact, after the halving, it seems like Bitcoin was stuck at 10,000 for so long. But really, we were completely according to plan, but we were at the lower end of the spectrum. Right now, we are going up. We are nowhere near being too overbought here. No. In fact, if we continue in this pace, at the 18th of April 2021, the Bitcoin price is going to be, on average, if you look at previous halvings, $100,000. And by May the 12th of 2021, $387,000. And then that is when you, according to history, have that blow off top, go down, enter the bear market. But on October 2021, $286,000 per Bitcoin. And imagine what that is going to do with altcoin markets. Imagine what that is going to do with Ethereum. And let's compare Bitcoin to gold and other assets. Which one has been performing the best? Well, this is Bitcoin compared to gold. I mean, gold compared to Bitcoin. Gold is going down. Bitcoin is still outperforming gold. S&P 500, Bitcoin still outperforming the S&P 500. Crude oil, Bitcoin still outperforming crude oil. So if you just hold Bitcoin, a lot of people are going to be shaken out by all of these moves right now. But if you just stay in Bitcoin, keep your HODL position, you are going to be completely fine. I want to talk a bit about my trade on Femex. This is still ongoing. If we actually reach these levels at 29,690, I'm going to continue building my long position here. But yeah, this can really take a very quick shot to the upside if things line up. But I think that we are going to still consolidate for a bit, but you never know with Bitcoin, guys. So that's that for this video, guys. I hope that you learned something from it. Make sure to watch the video popping up in the middle of this video right now. I will see you right there.